Welcome to Beyond the Data. I'm Dr. Phoebe Thorpe, and here with me today is Dr. Heather Strosnider from CDC's Environmental Public Health Tracking Program. Heather, thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
Today's session was really interesting about environmental health, and environmental health seems like it's the intersection of our environment and our health. Mm-hmm. Tell me how your program is helping us understand how our environment impacts our health.
Sure, absolutely. So yeah, our environment is everything that surrounds us. In the tracking program, we focus on chemical, physical, biological hazards that can be in our air, water, our communities, our homes. In our presentation today, I gave an example of air pollution and respiratory ED visits. Another example I briefly mentioned is radon. Radon's a naturally occurring element that is found in rocks and soil. It can seep into our homes from the ground, and so it's really important to test your homes for radon levels and to mitigate that if there seems to be a problem. But there's a lack of data on exactly where we should be testing homes for radon.
Oh, okay. So that makes sense to me, because as you were saying about your home being having radon in your home, I was thinking, oh, that's an individual problem. But what you're saying is that the tracking program is helping to put that together so people know where they might need to test for the radon, because they might their area might have increased risks.
Correct. So we're really trying to motivate people to have this test done. And we know some information from a geological perspective about where we think radon is, but it really can vary from house to house or neighborhood to neighborhood. And so by centralizing and standardizing data for tests that are occurring, we can help understand where we want to have future tests or where areas need further testing.
That's okay. That makes sense too, because what I hear you saying is that this testing is being standardized too, and that's also very important. The other thing that we heard today was about climate change, or just a little bit about climate change, but climate change and environmental health seem like they overlap a lot. How are they the same and how are they different?
Yeah, well, in my perspective, climate change is an environmental health issue. You know, climate change may lead to an increase in extreme weather events like storms, you know, hurricanes, flooding, even heat waves. And those are all physical hazards external to us, and they can cause health effects, injury, illness, even death. And so working with our climate change partners, we help to use data to understand where events might occur in the future and help communities adapt to those future risks. It's very similar to public health preparedness, and we collaborate with those programs as well. Whereas in public health preparedness, we're really focusing on the events that are occurring now, the communities that are experiencing heat waves, for example, now. But when it comes to climate change, we're looking to the future, and we're saying, where might heat waves occur in the future in communities that aren't already experiencing heat waves, and therefore they aren't already prepared to deal with those heat waves.
Heat waves, the changes in their environment from the climate change changes.
Right.
If that makes sense.
Correct.
The other thing that was very interesting was about the state of Massachusetts that's moving towards health in all policies. And I was really intrigued about how they're using the tracking data to make that possible, how you can look at how a change in something would affect the health. Can you tell me a little bit more about why decision makers would be looking to the tracking data to help make decisions?
Sure. So the unique thing about our program and the real value of our data is that it's fully vetted. It's developed the standard based on standards in collaboration with environmental and health partners at the national, state, and local level. We work with those partners to understand what the important environmental health questions are. We evaluate available data, we set those standards, we process the data, and we disseminate it in multiple ways through our tracking network. So not only do you have an increased access to data, but you have data that's been standardized across the US, that's been interpreted, and you have the expertise within these tracking programs to make sense of the data and to help to address decision makers' concerns and problems. So, you know, while it's one hand, it's the data, it's also the expertise.
And so you had also, so there's data and expertise. You had also mentioned that there were tools and that also individuals can access the data. Mm-hmm. How, if somebody at an individual level was interested in accessing the data, how would they go about doing that, and what are some of the things they might be able to explore on that?
Sure. So at the national level, we have our national tracking network, and you can visit that on the link provided here. And from that link, you can also reach all of our grantee portals, so at the state and local level. So at the national level on the tracking network, you can access data on things like air pollution, asthma, drinking water, birth defects, cancer, developmental disabilities, childhood lead poisoning. And then you can go to our state and local portals where you'll find similar data, also standardized in the same way, but additional data that have been developed at the state and local level to address state and local level concerns.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So you have national data and state and local data, mm-hmm. or state and local data, I should put mm-hmm. it that way. It actually sounds quite cool and interesting, even
yes.
though it's data.
Yeah.
So, but there must be more. What are you looking towards in the future, and where do you see the program going towards?
Sure. Well, I really do think we are just scratching the surface of what the tracking program and the network can be, and how it can help inform decisions related to environmental health. We're really eager to continue to grow our capacity at the national, state, and local level. And that's capacity both in technical and data management and data collection, but also in environmental health science and epidemiology, how we use that data to mm-hmm. inform those decisions. And we're also really, really interested in continuing to grow our partnerships and increase awareness about the tracking program and the network. We want to collaborate with decision makers, so to help them connect the data that they need to address the issue that they're concerned about, and ultimately help make informed decisions about programs or interventions or policies that can prevent or reduce the impact of environmental hazards on our health.
On our health. So it really will be health in all policy and actions. It's great. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Yeah, thank you for having me.
Yeah, and thank you for joining us. We'll see you next time on Beyond the Data.